This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hello once again, welcome to episode 42. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to solve a rational equation. We've done plenty of videos just talking about them, now we're going to actually solve them. Let's get started. Alright, our rational equation says we have 3x divided by x plus 1 plus 2 divided by x equals 3 divided by x squared plus x. The very first thing you should do when you have a rational equation is look for quadratics. And any quadratic expression that you see, factor it. We do have one quadratic expression here. That's x squared plus x. Well, what does this have in common? Well, they both have x in them. So we'll factor out the x. If we do factor out an x from both terms, we will have x plus 1 remaining. With that in mind, we'll rewrite our equation over here. The first term stays the same because there were no quadratics in it. So does the second term. The third term will become x times x plus 1. The second thing we'll do is find the LCD. If we want to have any chance of solving this, we'll need to combine all of these terms together. For that, we're going to have to find the LCD. To get the LCD, let's look at what terms we have in the denominators. And we definitely have x plus 1. That's got to be part of the LCD. We also have x as well. We'll have to put that there as well. In the third term, we have both x and x plus 1, which are both already in the LCD. So that our LCD is x times x plus 1. Now that we know the LCD, let's see what each term needs in order to reach the LCD. Our first term says x plus 1. What it's missing is the x. Let's make a note of that. So that our first fraction, we're going to put an x on the bottom and an x on the top. For our second term, it's already got an x, so it needs the part that it's missing. That's x plus 1. So for it, we'll put an x plus 1 on both the top and the bottom. The third term already has x times x plus 1, so it's okay. We don't need to do anything to it. Now we simply bring down what was already there. For the first term, we'll have 3x and x plus 1, just like it used to have. For the second term, we'll say 2 and x, just like it used to have. For the third term, we will still have 3 over x times x plus 1. So now we have all of our terms in their correct places. Our next job will be to simplify them. Let's simplify the first term first. We have x times 3x. Well, x times x is x squared with the 3 still there. We don't really have to simplify the denominator so much. We'll just keep that as it is. The second term, we have 2 times x and 2 times 1. 2 times x is 2x, and 2 times 1 is 2. Still over the x times x plus 1, since that's the LCD. The last fraction, we don't have to do anything to. We'll keep it the same. Now you might notice our equation is indeed second power. If you do have a second power equation, just like always when you have a second power equation, we're going to move all the terms to the same side. So this 3 has to move over. So now we'll have 3x squared plus 2x plus 2 minus 3, since this 3 must move over. Since they all have the same denominator, they will all share the same denominator. This is why we got the LCD in the first place. And now, it all equals 0. If we combine all the like terms we see, we'll have plus 2 and minus 3 would give us minus 1. The other terms can't be combined, so they stay the same. So our final fraction says 3x squared plus 2x minus 1 divided by x times x plus 1. Now that we have the equation fully simplified, let's try to solve it. I'll recopy the equation that we had. 3x squared plus 2x minus 1 divided by x times x plus 1. To find the solution, we're going to set the top part equal to 0, because that's what gave us our roots in the previous examples. The part on the bottom we have to set not equal to 0, because that's what gave us our asymptotes. Let's have a look at the roots first. For our roots, I will say we have 3x squared plus 2x minus 1 is equal to 0. When you have a second power equation, a good thing to try to do is factor it. Of course, there's also the quadratic formula, but factoring tends to be much faster. So let's think of two numbers that multiply to 3x squared. Well, the only ones I can think of are 3x and x. And then let's try to think of two numbers that multiply to negative 1. Well, there's only one way to get that, negative 1 and positive 1. Now let's make sure the middle terms work out. The outer terms are 3x times 1, which is 3x. The middle terms are negative 1 times x, which is negative 1x. If we add them together, we get 2x, and it turns out that is a match. So we do have this correctly factored. And let's set it equal to 0. Now, we can split it up into pieces. So we'll have 3x minus 1 equals 0, and x plus 1 equals 0. Let's solve the first piece. We'll move the 1 over to the right. 3x equals 1. If we divide both sides by 3, we'll have x equals 1/3 for our first solution. If we do the same to the other equation, we'll have x equals negative 1. However, it is not enough to get these two answers. We have to check also the asymptotes and make sure neither of these fall on the asymptotes. Let's set up that equation for the asymptotes. We'll have x times x plus 1 not equal to 0. If we split these up into two equations, we'll have x not equal to 0 and x plus 1 not equal to 0. The first equation is already solved, since x is already by itself. The other equation, we'll just subtract 1 from both sides, and we'll have x not equal to negative 1. So we have x not equal to negative 1, while this side says x is equal to negative 1. If you have x not equal to negative 1, while this one says x equal to negative 1, it's not really a solution, it's a whole. So this will not be considered part of our solution. However, the remaining solution, x equals 1/3, is not mentioned in the asymptotes, which means it is the correct solution. So our solution will be x equals 1/3. And that is how you solve a rational equation, and how you eliminate the wholes to avoid giving wrong answers. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you again next episode.